Macho Man Randy Savage. What do you have there?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Macho Man is the champion. Yeah. Wow. Picking away and unbelievable right there. Were you head waiter? Huh? Don't unbelievable things happen.
Could be.
Now, here's where it goes. Tito Santana, 1986. Hulk Hogan, 1986. Winning the belts from you is going to be easier than, hold this, taking candy away from a baby. Unbelievable. I could take all the candy and pour it on your head right now. But I ain't gonna. I'm gonna pour it over mine. Cause I ain't got no dignity, no I don't. Not when it comes to winning a World Heavyweight Championship belt. Aren't I something, man? Did you see me out here putting candy on my head?
Hey, Macho Man. Macho.
Right there.
Macho Man.
Okay, yeah.
Elizabeth has been a big part of your success.
Yeah.
Certainly, she is a very attractive addition to the World Wrestling Federation. You give her a lot of credit, do you not?
Why shouldn't I put candy on your head right now? But I could take it right behind myself and throw right on Elizabeth. Or I can take these glasses and smash them against my head.
Don't.
Show the intensity that I want. The World Heavyweight Championship belt. Elizabeth, get out of here right now. Get out of here.
How can you dismiss her like that?
Dismiss her like I'm dismissing Hulk Hogan, yeah. Hulk Hogan, man, understand that the belt will fall in 86. The World Heavyweight Championship belt will fall in 1986.
Now, is that a prediction or is that a promise?
It's a promise. Yes, it is. And I promise to you, the public out there, that you'll have a champion that you can be proud of. The world's greatest athlete. Ask Tito Santana what he is. He's a stepping stone to the World Heavyweight Championship belt. And I guarantee you, Elizabeth, and anybody out there, don't bet against the Macho Man. Not this year.
Thank you, Randy Savage. Randy Savage certainly has done.
We had! Say what? A whole lot of superstars on this stage here tonight. But I want y'all to know one thing. This is my house. And when I say who's
up, word attack skills and vocabulary too. Cover hits in the distance. It's all brand new. You're through. I'm interplanetary and like Doctor Who. So who?
Fuck your beef. No relief. I step on stage. Girls scream like I'm Keith.
What's up, everybody? Ringtime Pro Wrestling is back in the building. Keith and Keisha are here. Keisha, say hi to the people.
Hey, what's up, everybody? What's going on? Hope y'all enjoy your week and whatever. I know people gearing up for the Super Bowl and all that BS and whatever the hell, but, you know, I hope that today has been enjoyable for you people, because it's definitely been enjoyable for me.
All right. I have been enjoying myself. I spent most of my day working on a car that I still didn't get things finished, but Still, all is good. All is fair in love and war. My TV came a day early. Thank you, Jesus. Other than that, it's been an interesting week. We got a lot to talk about. We're going to cover all the bases. There's some good, there's some bad, there's some new, there's some old. There's a lot of rumors in the pipeline. So we're going to talk about them. We're going to get them all covered. And see what props. So, this should be a very entertaining, action-packed episode of Ringtime Pro Wrestling. It's the first day of Black History Month. I have not sponsored a Black History Moment, even though you listen to a black podcast. Should help you understand a little bit. But yeah, we're going to talk about just about everything, right? Keish, I live on the outskirts, and thank God, because I don't have to deal with all these nut jobs. So, the Super Bowl is going down Sunday. There'll be a mass exodus on Monday, where people will be pouring out of the city. Thank you. Don't come again. Other than that, man, I ain't got no complaints. I'm good. If I was smart, I would have said, let's start this show at 7:30. The tired monster is chasing me, so we're going to do what we got to do to get this thing over with, right?
Right.
Okay, so we're going to start our week backwards and work our way forward like we usually do. So last week, very action-packed week, the city of Phoenix, Arizona, and the state of Arizona got blessed with 4 days of wrestling action. One of the biggest days of the year, right? One of the biggest weekends of the year. Royal Rumble. The road to WrestleMania has officially started. We are rolling downhill towards the end of last year's calendar. Because of the WWF, the year starts in April with WrestleMania, and that's where it ends. So, the day after WrestleMania is a new year with new beginnings. Everything leading up to that, it just is what it is. So, we're going to talk. We're going to talk a lot. We're going to have a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
NXT TakeOver, right?
Ooh, it was good. It was good.
TakeOver is always good. TakeOver very rarely ever misses. So let's talk TakeOver. So, it's TakeOver. 5 matches. They got it in. They did a hell of a job. So, we opened up the show with a very good match. 2010, the War Raiders. You may have known them as War Machine if you watch ROH. But the War Raiders. Which one is married to Sarah Logan? Do you know? Is it Hanson or... Either way, one of them married to Sarah Logan. But anyway, and as far as we know, they live this Viking thing. Like, that shit is not a gimmick. But, so they came, they faced the Undisputed Era, who I don't know if they get enough credit. Because for the last, like, year and a half, man, those guys have held down NXT. I mean, those guys have really been, like, backboners to NXT.
Right.
I thought Adam Cole was never world champ, but that's neither here nor there. Very good match, a lot of back and forth. They gave guys good time. They did what they needed to do. But at the end of the day, man, the Royal Raiders was just too physically opposing, just too strong. Even when they got in a bad way, they wasn't never really fully out of it. Like, from the beginning of the bell, you did not see a lot of chance for the Undisputed Era. Like, it was a decisive win. So, that happens. We have new tag team champions, right?
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And, hey man, that's a very deep pool of tag teams. The Street Profits are still down there. Fortunate Sons are down there. The Undisputed Era hasn't left yet, which, I mean, come on, eventually it got to, right?
Right.
So there's a lot going on, man. And it's a lot of opportunity. But yeah, good job, War Raiders. Matt Riddle defeated Cassius Ohno because I didn't really care for the match or the idea of him even having it. I can gloss over it, but Keisha, you got any words for it?
I don't. Really, I kind of glossed over it myself. I didn't really pay too much. I paid attention to it enough, you know, to watch it, but it really wasn't an interesting match to me. Not saying that the match wasn't okay, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was still good, but at the same time, it wasn't, and I didn't have any, like, vested interest into what was going on with it. I mean, as far as being between them two. Like, I think it's just something that they just needed something for Cassius to do. And I understand it. So, you know, we get it. We fully understand it. We got it. But all in all, I don't discredit it. It's just, you know, just no one either.
No, I get it. Gargano challenged Ricochet for the NXT North American Heavyweight title. I put this as strong running for match of the night. I'm not really just ready to hand it over as we're talking about the show, but very strong running, very good ship, match. It showed off the athleticism, but it did go too far. Because sometimes Ricochet, just like that Will Ospreay match she had, it's like, it was good, but it was like, it took me out of like the sense of belief. Like, it's like, oh wow, this has became too acrobatic. And not just because it came too acrobatic, but there are moves that obviously it requires help from the other person.
Right.
And you gotta stay away from those kind of moves in wrestling to me. Because you try to still give the presentation that you're trying to do something that's legit. Whether, you know.
Right.
We'll get down that another time for another place, but you gotta not do stuff that's just like, why would anybody do that anyway? But,
all right.
Side note, good match. Gargano is a good technician, good strategist, great storytelling. And Johnny Gargano defeated Ricochet and got the North American title. One of his first individual belts. And something big. So, Keish, what did you think of all of this?
Ooh, I thought the match was incredible. It's one match that I expected to be as good as it was, but I think it's one of my favorite matches, like, period. Like, it's definitely worth saying. Like, I really wasn't for, you know, all the high flying and all that myself. I thought it was a bit much at certain points in the match, but at the same time, they made it work to where I wasn't bored. You know what I'm saying? There wasn't a point in the match where I felt like, you know, okay, this is, you know, a little long, this is a little drawn out. You know, it's not, because Ricochet and Gargano are both incredible wrestlers, so to put them in a match together, you know, I felt like definitely made it worth it. I'm glad to see Gargano with the belt around his waist. I feel like he has proven that he deserves this spot a long time ago. You know what I'm saying? Like, personally, I would love to see him be NXT champion. North American champion is definitely a good look for him. I'm not discrediting it at all. I am glad. I'm actually happy about the outcome. Of course, we know this is not going to be the end of between him and Ricochet. So, you know, as we go along, we'll see what happens. But it's definitely worth it. It was definitely worth the time that it was. And, you know, there wasn't a second. I feel like there wasn't a second of the match that was wasted. So that was just my whole take on it. And I'm glad that, you know what, I'm also happy about is that there was no outside involved body, because they could have, of course, had it written in there, you know, that Ciampa comes out and, you know, decides that he's going to give his two cents or just make a presence, just be a distraction or, you know, whatever. But, you know, Adam Cole could have came out and, you know, got involved or whatever. But I'm glad that there wasn't any outside involvement in this match at all. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad that they didn't decide to go that route and they didn't decide to have anybody show up in order to try and create some kind of distraction for that. I'm glad that they just let them two just fight it out, because it made it even better than it was originally expected. So, you know, all in all, I'm happy of the results. I'm really happy about the results.
Right. Now, a match I was not happy about the results for. Shayna Baszler successfully defended her belt against Bianca Belair.
I was mad.
Her two cronies came down. Bianca don't got a crew because she, you know, she rolling. Yeah.
You know, it's funny. The only person, because what they don't, of course they don't. I follow Bianca on Instagram. I follow WWE on Instagram. And right. I think NXT too as well and everything. So, right. her and Lacey was cool and whatever. Her and Lacey Evans was cool and whatever. But at the same time,
so
they've been it's kind of been a hoard a little bit that Lacey's getting moved to the main stage. So it's like she's kind of just out. But of course Bianca is out there. You know, she's like, hey, I fight for me. I'm for me, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, but I just hate that just like I just talked about with the Gargano Ricochet match. I hate that they had to get Jessamine and Marina involved. Like, it's like, come on, y'all. Like, I could have let that be. You know what I'm saying? Especially because this, I feel like it would have been more of a compelling story if there wasn't any outside involvement. Bianca Belair was undefeated. So I felt like had they just let them to fight it out by themselves, the match would have been way more better. You know, it would have been better just off that alone. I didn't think it was a bad match. Don't get me wrong. I felt like both women were incredible. But it just would have definitely, especially when they knocked down a referee and all that kind of stuff, like, it would have been fine without the outside involvement of Shayna's two friends. Like, it just would have made a more compelling storyline, especially since the outcome was Bianca losing anyway. It was just kind of like, well, had she lost on her own merit, I think that it would have been okay. You know, I would have been more okay with it, but at the same time, you know, I didn't want to see her lose anyway. Like, it just sucks that she lost in the first place, but to have them have gotten involved, regardless of if they beat her up or if they didn't, it just wasn't, I feel like it wasn't necessary. So that was just my whole opinion of the whole situation. You know, I hated that Shayna retained. I really did. Because I really wanted this for Bianca. And I feel like had she won the belt, that her whole undefeated streak, her whole undefeated storyline and everything, I think it would have been perfect. You know what I'm saying? Like, she could have ran this, even if it was only to the next takeover. You know what I'm saying? She could have had, they could have had a good run with her. But now that she done lost, that has all been tainted. So, you know, she can't even go off of that anymore. And it sucks. I have to honestly tell you that it sucks. But, you know, that's let me get off my soapbox because I can go on about this all night.
right. No, but I get it, right? So, Tommaso Ciampa, defeated Aleister Black. That was not much of a surprise. Retains the NXT title. Now, after that, Chopper goes up the ramp, stands there, celebrates with the fans. Kind of rare for a show, but NXT fans are different. Out comes Gargano. And they stand there and have a moment of, like, celebration. Because the two guys who just drifted apart, did whatever, was able to come together for this thing.
Right.
So.
Wow. I actually was like, I was pretty shocked, you know. I was. I've been trying to make sense of it ever since we seen the scene. Like, it was just kind of like, all right, so y'all had Ciampa beat up on Gargano. They've been having this back and forth. They've been going through a lot of stuff. And, you know, it's like, but I kind of understand it a little. I do. You know what I'm saying? Especially with Ciampa egging on Gargano. You can do this by yourself. You know what I'm saying? You got this. And Gargano's like, shut up, leave me alone. But, you know, he wins the title. He wins the North American Championship. Ciampa retains. You know, I actually understand him coming out there. and celebrating with them. It's mind-boggling, but at the same time, somewhere along the line, it makes sense to me. You know, I feel like there's this kind of brotherhood thing between the two. And that's where I get it. You know, I feel like it's one of them kind of like one of them shield moments. You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, yeah, that's my brother. We're going to fight. We're going to do this. We're going to do that. But at the end of the day, you know, I'm going to come out here. We're going to support each other. Now, did you see the footage for what happened after the pay-per-view went off the air?
Yeah. No, I saw it. It got intense. Now, I don't understand how Adam Cole got mixed up into this, right?
Well, I think I do. So, Adam Cole lost the North American title to Ricochet.
Right.
So with Velveteen Dream coming out there, he's in the face of Gargano. I don't know. To tell the truth, you really don't know who he's in the face of. Gargano just happened to jump in between him and Ciampa. He's in Gargano's face. Adam Cole comes out there. He don't like nobody. It's just kind of, it's weird. Now, I have to honestly say that I can understand why him coming out there is confusing, because it's kind of like, all right, but what you got to do with this? You know what I'm saying? But then, you know, Aleister comes out too, and it's like, okay, so what is going on here? Because, and then, of course, Ricochet. And it's just like, all right, well, I feel like with this whole title picture, is you see what could arguably be the top six single male superstars of NXT out on the stage, you know what I'm saying? And they going at each other's throats. Everybody wants those belts. Everybody wants those belts. The two that's holding them right now, of course, they're standing there and they're defending themselves. But the other four, they're just trying to, you know, it's all been just constant BS and, you know, it's just been a lot. And I feel like this is just a way for them to show that there's a running for these titles. Of course, we see what the end result was as far as the whole debacle in the first place. But, to me, I just feel like there's substance there, you know, with Adam Cole and Velveteen and Ricochet and Aleister Black. They're all out there on that stage. There's substance there because they all want the same goals. They all want gold, regardless of the North American Championship, the NXT title. All of them want to hold a title. You know what I'm saying? Now, of course, everybody shoots for the top title because everybody wants to be the champion. Now, come on now. Right? Everybody wants to be NXT champion of some sort. Regardless if it's the male, female, you know, that's just how it goes. But, you know, with the North American Championship in the mix, you know, it gives them something else to shoot for. You know what I'm saying? I'm whole gold regardless. You know, if you don't have a tag team partner, you know, this is the next best thing. So, I understood all of it from the start. You know, I questioned a lot of it at first because it was confusing to me. It was like, all right, I didn't wonder why Adam Cole was out there. Like, with Ricochet and Aleister, I understood. Velveteen just, like, started shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was understandable. I think Adam Cole, with him being especially seen as kind of the unofficial leader of Undisputed Era, like, I feel like that was his whole role when being out there. If you're going to be that top dog or whatever, of course you're going to need gold. So even though he don't like Ciampa or Gargano, him being a heel, they threw him on their side. You know, but I don't feel like he was out there to fit at anybody, of course, but himself. I think he just wanted to be in the mix. You know what I'm saying? Like, and yeah, if I was him, I'd probably go out there too.
Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong. I think that's what a lot of it was, but So you had Alistair did Ricochet shows up and people want revenge. Bills have been lost. But I expect a big Pier 6 brawl. Would it take all? But yeah, so that's that. On the Royal Rumble, Keish. The Rumble! The show opened up with Asuka defending her title successfully against Becky Lynch. I'm not going to give you how the end result. I'll talk about it real, like how I felt in real time. This is bullshit. What they doing?
Right.
They laid it out correctly.
Right.
It was enough time for her to recover and then get into that other match. But, a little wrong. But, you know, I get it. But,
right.
Very talented young man. Good to see him going to the WWE Hall of Fame. But, yeah. That was that.
Man, Becky, to me, is, they cut her short at times, and it sucks. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah, but
cut her short at times, and it sucks.
Yeah, I thought the loss to Asuka was that. I thought the loss to Asuka was like, yeah, we'll show you getting popular, yo.
Right, right.
But, you know, that's how they do.
I said, you know what? But you know what? I felt like they had bigger plans for things. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to trust in this. You know what I'm saying? I didn't really want to... At that point in the pay-per-view, I didn't want to just be like, all right, that's the y'all bullshit. I don't got time for this. Fuck it. Or whatever. But...
Hold on. That ain't a real explanation?
Huh?
That's not a real explanation? Does it sound legit to me?
Yeah, like, I really wanted them to, I wanted Becky to win. I wanted Becky to have the title again. But then when she lost, I said, okay, fine. I let them have it for right now. I let them have it for right now. But when we get to SmackDown Tuesday, they better have a better excuse for this, because I ain't got time. Okay? I love Becky. When she was good, I love her as a heel. Like, I just love Becky Lynch. I've always been a like Becky Lynch fan, so I just wanted her to have her time. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just want her to have her just do. And I actually want that title back around her waist. But at the same time, you know what I'm saying? I'm glad that Asuka is holding the belt right now. I'm glad that she is. I'm glad that she's at the top when it comes to SmackDown women. That means that this should make for a very compelling WrestleMania match if she doesn't lose her title before then. I don't see that happening, but, you know, with WWE, you never know. And, of course, I'm going to say that later, but you just never know what can happen. So, oh no, I was okay. I think I was all right. I wasn't all right with the result, but I was all right at the moment, at that time. I was like, all right, fine. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's just see how this goes. So.
Yep. But yeah, Asuka, successful for the SmackDown Women's title. Shane O'Mac and The Miz are the SmackDown Tag Team Champions?
Okay, so there's a lot. There's a lot going into that.
I've had a week to prepare for this, and I'm still like, oh, who did that?
Right, like I just really need to understand what's happening with this whole Shane Miz situation, because I really feel, you know, you get real skeptical. You get real skeptical. Because Miz is known to just flip the script. You know what I'm saying? So it's nothing to just one day he just decides to just turn on Shane. Or, you know, it's real. I just don't trust it. You know what I'm saying? They sit in here, they celebrating with his dad, with Miz's dad and all that kind of stuff. And you know what's crazy? The match was really good. That match was really good. But Shane got to sit down somewhere, man. Like, I'm going to need him to chill.
Really?
Like, I really do. I would really need him to chill because it's like, Shane, you got to remember, bro. Like, you can't be out here, you know, doing all these stunts and flippets and that. No, you got to chill. Like, you already, it's bad enough you out here having matches. Like, at some point, you gonna have to hang that up. Like, glad you were in great shape and everything, but dude, like, come on, man. You know, you ain't that dude that was facing Stone Cold and all that. Like, I'm going to need you to calm that down. But it was still a good match, though. I have to say I enjoyed it, you know. I just didn't expect that outcome.
Right.
I really didn't. So, I mean, I really don't know. Honestly, Keith, I don't know what to make of it. I just don't. It's too much for me. And when you try to wrap your mind around it and you try to, you know, you try to make sense of it, it's really more and more confused. Like, I honestly just can't figure out, like, where this is going. I don't know how to even, like, explain it. Like, yeah, so they tag team champions, all right? Like, how that happened? Like, it's...
Yeah, no. I mean, I don't know if it's a setup for something bigger down the road, but it's just like, and Keish, I love Shane, right? I think I've seen all the Shane McMahon wrestling I need to see, right?
All right.
But that being said, hey, that little moonsault he did or whatever?
Man, I ain't gonna lie, that was dope.
I was like, I didn't know he could do that, right?
Right.
But it's like, hey, 8047?
Right.
Keesh.
Right.
You know I'm creeping up on the 4-0 this year. I would dare. No. quote my father, Keith Hosea, fuck you. You got some friends, fuck them too. No.
Look, I'll be 32 next month. I'll be damned. Like, you ain't no way in hell. Yeah, no. Are you serious? Like, no. No. I know some 20-somethings that would never. Like, they would never. Like, he's 47 doing the thing. I'm like, when he did that moonsault, I was done. I was like, bruh, like, yeah, just gonna give him the belt. Like, he might as well. You can't deny them the titles after that. Like, there's just no way. Like, yeah. I don't care what he was wrestling for. Like, after that, he has to win. There's just no other way around that. Like, period. It's not. You gotta give him whatever the hell he wrestling for. Just go ahead. Just have to. Like, because you can't have him pull moves like that and he loses. Like, that's just not gonna work. It won't. Like, that'll turn ugly real quick for everybody. So nah. He did that. I was floored. I said, man, this is it. This is it.
Right. Ronda Rousey successfully defended the Raw Women's title against Sasha Banks. Very good match. Very entertaining. Sasha was chosen, I believe, because they knew she would get the show over. And I don't know. Here's the thing. This episode ended last week, but today is the first day of the month, which is February, first day of Black History Month. Sasha fell victim to a thing that a lot of black wrestlers fall victim to. Warm up. Test out. I mean, she had an amazing match, but here's the thing. We knew Ronda Rousey can't lose. I wouldn't even have Ronda on TV every week. It's like, she can't lose. Look, man.
Right.
Just get the promos you need from her and move on. Y'all will be feather.
Right.
Check it out. But no, we knew she couldn't lose because the big match is waiting on her in April. She got to have a strap for this. So what's coming? Becky Lynch was the Royal Rumble, Keish.
All right.
She took a lot of the time.
She.
Yeah.
Well, okay. So, I, honestly, I am glad that they allowed her to take Lana's place. I am glad that she was able to enter. I am very glad that she won. And I, you know what? I have to honestly say that I was rooting for Charlotte to win, but to tell the truth, Keith, I feel like this is better. I feel like this, and this is why, because Charlotte, her reputation and her resume is impeccable. She has many accolades, of course. She has been doing extremely, like, she's been fucking excellent since she started in NXT. And, well, actually, she was survivor standing, she was part of NXT. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. She has all these titles, and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And it's, for someone of her magnitude, it's expected of her to, of course, win things like this. So for the winner to be Becky, I felt like that's what made this 10 times better. Because Becky, I feel like, is severely underrated at times. And they don't give her her just due. And when she won the Royal Rumble, I said, thank God. You know what I'm saying? I was rooting for Charlotte because, of course, we didn't see this turn coming. We didn't. We didn't see this turn coming. You know, who knew Lana was going to get hurt and somebody was going to have to take her place? You know what I'm saying? That was a swerve that we, I know one, of course. So with Becky, when Becky entered, I was like, all right, yeah, come on, man. I would have hated it if Becky had got entered into the Royal Rumble and still lost. Like it would have sucked ass. Like, it just, I would have been pissed. I would have been pissed. But the fact that she actually won, like, I was ecstatic. I am so glad, because I feel like her versus Ronda, you know, in my mind at the time, you know, before anything else, like, her versus Ronda was the perfect setup. Now, people out there that are disagree, you know what I'm saying, Charlotte would have been better, blah, blah, blah. The reason why I say that is because Becky is that unexpected swerve that you don't see coming, but you're glad it did. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like there's a lot of expectation on Charlotte's shoulders to certain things, but I'm like, if you talk about the four horsewomen of WWE, all of them are impeccable wrestlers. Charlotte Flair gets talked about a lot because she's Charlotte Flair, but at the same time, she ain't no slouch. She's earned every single thing that she has gotten in the WWE, period. But I feel like at times discredited, and Becky definitely has got the shortest end of the stick when it comes to those four. So I feel like at this point, she really gets to show her worth, and especially with her being a heel right now, like, this is perfect. This is perfect, and I'm happy for her. And I know I'm going on and on, but but I had a whole week to think about this, Keith, and I had to get it out there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had to really, I just really wanted to get it all out there, because I could put this all in a post, of course, on Facebook or something like that, but I'm glad I'm doing it here, because y'all got to hear it out of my mouth, man. Y'all got to hear it from me. This is, I'm I am thoroughly happy with the results of the Women's Royal Rumble. All right, I'm done. I think I finished this. That's it for me. But, I mean, it could have went another way. It could have. Glad it didn't. But it could have went another way. It could have been. You know, ultimately, too. I think it should have been Bayley, Charlotte, and Becky to end this match out. But that's neither here nor there, too. You know? I think that Nia... I don't think that Nia was a bad placement for the final three, but I just kind of wanted to see what it would have been like if Bayley was there instead. You know, the three or the four course women of WWE battling it out for the title of the women, the winner of the Royal Rumble, like, you know. Because, you know, Bayley was in there taking heads.
Right.
She was like, I don't care. We all in here for ourselves, people. I'm not upset about it. I'm happy about all of it. So there was not a disappointing thing about that match at all. There was nothing disappointing about the Women's Royal Rumble at all. It ended all right. Just like it should have.
All right, so we go down the list. Daniel Bryan defeats AJ Styles, retains WWE Championship. So this match is interesting because I guess Eric Rowan is going to be a heater for Daniel Bryan.
I'm confused at his whole role in this situation. Like, the fact when he walked out, I was like, what is he doing here? Like, are they done with the Bludgeon Brothers? They was just like, that ain't gonna work.
Yeah, I think they're done for now at least, right?
And then I wonder too, where is Luke Harper? Like, I had way too many questions.
Well, I think he might still be out. See, I mean, they were both separated and it was done because of injuries, but... I guess Roy was available, and they used him in the match. I didn't like the way they used him particularly, but it sold a few million copies, right. You know. But, yeah, duh, that's something. So we have that. What did you think of Brock Lesnar and Finn Balor?
I'm not going to lie. I was kind of upset. By it all, because with Brock's matches, especially nowadays, you don't get a lot of competitiveness, so to speak. Like, there's no real, like, back and forth at times. So, you get a lot of, we're going to start this match out with there being a possibility of him losing. And then, you know, then it just becomes a smash match. And it's like, all right, what was the point? You know, I personally thought that Finn put up a good fight.
Yes, he did. Yes.
Really. He put up a good fight. I don't discredit Finn for that. He put up a great fight. I wasn't pleased with the outcome, of course. I really honestly, at this point, just want to see what it would be like for somebody else to be champion. I was actually happy when Roman Reigns was champion. I just hated, of course, the way that went down, but for Brock to be champion is a little different because,
right.
You know, I like the champion being on TV regularly. Even if it's not every week, you know what I'm saying? It could be, you know, a more often thing. I just don't like the fact that the champion of Raw, you will only see when he's getting ready to defend the title at a pay-per-view. And it's not every pay-per-view, of course. He could be off TV for like 2 or 3 months sometimes until, you know, something like Royal Rumble, WrestleMania, SummerSlam, Survivor Series, you know, a couple more every pay-per-views in between. And it's like, all right, that's it. And then he just makes random appearances here and there, but it's not regular enough for me. It's not often enough for me. I personally feel like Finn deserves to have a spot like that, especially since Finn never necessarily, he didn't lose the title when he had it. If it wasn't for his injury, you know, he would have still been the champion at that time. So it sucks that, you know, he's just kind of been bumped to where he is. It's like, damn. Like, so y'all just decided after that, like, y'all just not even going to consider him being in the title picture anymore. You know, and it's terrible in my eyes. But I really am glad that he was in the match to begin with. I just hate the outcome of it. Like, I'm gonna put it out there. Not a big Brock Lesnar fan. I don't think I ever have been. So, and I'm not biased, you know, like, I think there's been times in his career where I feel like he's done very well. He's done good, but, like, nowadays, I could do without, in all honesty. I could do without. And I get the whole, you know, why he was in the Raw and everything, like, what his role is, but it don't really do anything for me. So, you know, they need a new champion. They need a new champion for Raw. They really do. And he ain't it. I'm just saying. But that's my 2 cents on that. So, I gotta chill, because I'm being real descriptive tonight.
Right.
I'm all in my feelings right now. But I can't help it. Like, these folks be invoking me. I ain't got time.
I mean, and that leads us up to the Men's Royal Rumble. Won by one Seth Rollins, which I was very ecstatic because you know my views on Rollins. I think he's the guy who should have the keys to the car. What'd you think of the match?
Right. I thought it was good. And you know what? I realized anybody that had that night, except Becky, they weren't involved in either Royal Rumble. And you know what? It shows me that you have enough man and woman power to where you don't need that to happen. I was actually glad about that. I was actually excited about that point. And I was happy with the results of the Men's Royal Rumble. I'm glad that, and with the way it did, I'm glad it ended the way it did. You know, it was a really good. I'm not going to lie. Like, watching it the whole time, it was really, really good. I kind of held my breath a little bit. I wanted to see if they was going to have, like, any surprise entrance, like, you know, new people or anything. But I'm glad that I'm actually happy with the way that it went. I'm happy the way that it went. And I'm not disappointed. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm good, great with the outcome. You know, I thought everybody fought well. of course, Kofi had his shenanigans. But it was awesome. It was awesome. And I am glad, you know, that Seth Rollins is the one. I feel he deserves it. And anybody else, you know, and it's funny because if anybody else would have won. I depending on who it was, I wouldn't have been, you know, I would have been okay with it. But I'm glad it was him. I'm glad it was him because I felt like, you know, he deserved to be in that main event at WrestleMania. He really does. And I feel like it's a little overdue, you know. It's way overdue. So, but kudos to Seth. Seth is definitely one of my favorite wrestlers right now. I won't ever deny that. Like, he is definitely one of my favorite wrestlers right now. So, I'm excited. I am. I have to honestly say, I'm excited. I just want to see how the rest of this is going to go. So. Yep. That's freaking Rollins, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes. Rollins wins the Rumble. It's the final match. There's nothing really to add to it. And we move forward. But what we're going to do is do our break, as per usual. And then we'll be back. And from there, we're going to talk about what this thing all looks like going forward. The recaps will be short, because I did not realize that we went almost an hour just talking about the two pay-per-views. Yeah. So, yeah. Here's a break, and we'll be back. Hold on, I just forgot to do that.
Great show of respect. What Ronda Rousey attempted to do last night with Sasha Banks, but Banks is a sore loser.
Ronnie, I told you I'd find a way back to you again. Now, for about a year now, I've been hearing about this baddest woman on the planet. But the last time I came to your show, I dropped you right there. And even after that, you never came looking for me to prove that you're the baddest. So, Ronnie, I've come looking for you to prove you're not. And you've heard about this, but last night I won the Royal Rumble match. And unlike Seth Rollins, I don't need much time to think. I choose you.
Oh, yeah!
All right, everybody, we are back. Birthdays. Birthdays are fun. Do you realize today is Ronda Rousey's birthday?
Old as Ronda. Ain't she about the same age as me?
Exactly the same age as you. Born in 1987.
Yeah,
yes. You are Ronda Rousey old. Which is not a bad old to be. Not a bad old to be. Not so bad to be that old. So, yeah, no, that's going down. Tomorrow, well, probably a lot of people get this show. Brian Cage will be celebrating a birthday. Isla Dawn will be celebrating a birthday. Sunday, Super Bowl Sunday. Do you know, man, it is a loaded day of birthdays. What Devin Taylor will be celebrating a birthday. Marty Jannetty will be celebrating the birthday on Sunday. The late, great Kerry Von Erich, Texas Tornado himself. Then Haku, the legend Haku, pops of the current Japanese New Japan tag team, Gorillas of Destiny. multiple-time tag team champion of WWF, known as the most dangerous man of his time, and that was not in the ring, that was out of it. There are stories of somebody's eyeball getting yanked out, so yeah, shouts out to Haku.
Gross.
Yeah, man, but didn't care.
Ugh. Yeah. Even if it's a rule, that's nasty. Ugh.
Yeah, that's yeah. Disgusting. But, with that being said, the news. So, I've settled this to the news segment. Generally, I probably would just come out early in the show, but let's get this off the table. So, you know what? Now I'm thinking about the news. I was thinking about something I should have mentioned during Royal Rumble. I don't know if I should backtrack during that or I'll come back to it. I don't know. Well, let me just get it out my chest so I know it's gone and I don't have to remember if I've said it or not. Royal Rumble, men's Royal Rumble match. Kishu was number 30.
Oh, it was R-Truth.
Correct.
R-Truth was number 30.
And he came out jigging. Let me tell you what's up. Okay. You know how I feel about that.
I was dancing too. I'm like, get it.
See?
Okay, let me stop. All right.
Here you go. I remember the first time I saw it. I'm looking around the room. It's just me in the room. And I'm talking to myself like, we gonna really do this for all these white people? Hey man, I'm particular about black folks and how we present ourselves. I am. And there's a few times I have a moment where I'm like, look, I don't know if we should be doing this for all these white folks. They can't handle it, Keish. They can't handle it.
I was at home.
Yeah.
I'm terrible.
I don't need Bob from accountant walking up to me like, hey, what's up? No. No, buddy. Nope. Not doing it. Not today. That's why I don't like that. Get around. I like wrestling. It only takes one, Keish. It only takes one.
Nope. You get that clothesline out of nowhere.
Nope.
Like, don't hate what's up me. I don't know you.
Yeah. And that'd be his defense in court. Like, man, I was just wrestling. I'm like, man, I didn't agree to this shit. But yeah. So.
Okay. All right. Let's go on. I'm sorry. I had to.
Truth is number 30. He did not make it to the ring because he got bum rushed by Nia Jax. Nia Jax enters the ring. She enters the match. Okay, a lot of people said a lot of different things. A lot of people were pissed about this, right?
Mm-hmm.
I was more pissed of the execution than the overall thing. And this is the thing. I know intergender wrestling is popular. I know it is the right. Buzz all over the internet. I know people love this shit out of it. Keish. That made me uncomfortable. I know it's not the basket. It's the, it was just the execution and watching it. So, Nia goes down. She's a powerhouse, yada, yada, yada. She's taking dudes out. She threw out Mustafa Ali. And it's the idea of, look, I'm not going into the whole sexist idea or well, men can beat up women, yada, 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 which is not really sexist. It's kind of true. That's why we freak out with violence against women. I didn't like the idea that, like, I'm like this. When I watched four dudes gang up on Nia Jax, trying to beat on her, you know, to get her out the ring, you know what I mean, on it, that just was uncomfortable as shit.
The execution of it went completely left for me. In all honesty, I feel like I understood why they had her beat up Trunks and, you know, enter in at 30 instead of him. I think that part of it was okay to me, because if you would have just had her enter in at one of the youngers, it would have caused more of an outrage, considering she would have been taking the spots of, you know, one of the men that could have been doing it. I mean, granted, I get why they did it the way they did it. You know what I'm saying? Well, as far as that goes. But then when you have four men surrounding her to try and get her out, it's like, all right, this is a little much, because of the simple fact that they're men. You know, it's like, people were uncomfortable with her being in the match entirely. But, you know, I feel like if you don't watch wrestling outside of WWE, then you're not going to see too much interchangeable wrestling going on. You're not going to see it at all if all you watch is WWE. Good. But I didn't have a problem with her. Of course I didn't have a problem with her being in the match. That part of it, yeah, I did have a problem with, because I was like, do y'all really need four dudes, you know, to... And I'm pretty sure there's an argument of, well, she's in a match, you know what I'm saying, so she's fair game. And it's like, yeah, I get that part, but four men, you know what I'm saying, to take out one woman? Like, they didn't do that to Beth Phoenix, you know what I'm saying, Awesome Kong. They didn't do anything like that to them. So it's kind of like, you know, why would y'all do this to her? You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, that could have went a whole nother way than it did. Because it was unnecessary. It was unnecessary. I understand Mania is a powerhouse and everything, but she was still a woman in a men's match. And it's like, of course it's like, well, then, you know, I if y'all want my personal opinion, I support intergender wrestling. I think it's awesome. It's not like this is stuff that they're forced into, per se. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have no problem with it. The little sweet Keith, I read somewhere that Nia hurt Archer. I don't know how true that is or not, but when she had slammed him into the wall, like, he was pissed after the fact, because he was like, well, you're gonna really hurt. I've seen a lot of outrage about her hurting people than I have about her being in the Rumble, in the men's Rumble.
Yeah, if they were to break the internet, they succeeded. Mm-hmm. So I got that out the way. So now the big thing that we need to get out the way is Dean Ambrose. Some people believe it's a work. Some people believe it's 100% legit. For their purposes, WWE entered a statement saying Dean will not be back. And he probably has to educate himself to things that are going.
I don't like that they made an official statement about it. I feel like if there were to have been more negotiations as far as contract goes, and, you know, even if it is a work, like, it's kind of like, that's a good, okay. I don't really like the fact that they made an official statement, because we're not there yet. I feel like this is way early, and even though it's like, I mean, everybody wants fans to know and everything, but it's kind of like, it's like It's February. It wasn't even February, you know, when they... It's now February 1st, so y'all didn't even make it to February before y'all put the statement out. His contract ain't up to April. And it's like, how do you work in an environment with someone, you know, he on his way out. And they're like, well, we gone at the WrestleMania and all that kind of stuff. And I'm like, well, what do you plan to do with him until then? Like, the whole thing that from one article that I read, he's not happy with the direction of his character after he came back. And they've been in negotiations and they just don't agree. And I get that part, but like, damn, like y'all just put it out there. Like, well, he ain't coming at after, you know, he ain't coming back after his contract's up, this, that, and the third. And it's like, so, and y'all not fighting for him before, and he just ain't for it. Is he just saying, you know, that I'm out? Or are y'all not, you know, I feel like it's something there that's missing. If this is real, you know, it's something there that's missing that is not being explained. And I really want to know, like, the whole, you know, story about what this is. Because Dean is too valuable of a wrestler, I feel like, to just let go. You know what I'm saying? But I know that if you're not agreeing with the terms of your contract that you're negotiating, then of course you're not going to want to stay. So, I don't know, man. I don't know how this is going or what's going on or what's happening, but I would hate to see him leave, honestly. I don't want to see Dean Ambrose go. You know, I feel like there's way too much that you can do with him.
Yeah, so here's the thing about Dean leaving.
Yeah.
Do I think it's a work? Everything that I've talked to people, it kind of, because I've had a week to sit on it, I haven't had to rush to do this thing. This seems legit, right? The way he's going out seems a little rough. Like, they counted Monday as them kind of trying to write him off TV. You know, find ways to make him look bad, stuff like that. I don't know if that's going to be a thing because his wife still worked there. I don't know the reason for him stepping away either. I don't know if he's going to go All Elite. From what I heard, his contract doesn't have a 90-day clause, so that's interesting. I also don't know what he looks like away from the WWE. You know what I'm saying? Here's the thing. The value that's in Dean Ambrose is the value that's associated with him in context of the Shield. His main event status is based on his opponents like Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. Having him as being just Dean Ambrose, because even if it wasn't them, by proxy to them, he was able to challenge up the mantle. Not going to be able to do that no more. So, I don't know. Like, I don't know if the dude is going to a new wrestling company or if he's just going to clear his head. For y'all to know, right, that WWE travel schedule is a beast. Like, much props to anybody who goes through it. I would say, nah. Well, I'm saying I'm lying. I'd be like, yeah. More money, please. Excuse me, Vince McMahon, can you open the money tap? I need more money, please. Yo, and I'm there. No, it's not it, but... listen, go to the board news. So we talked about Dean Ambrose. Jeff Jarrett and Shane Helms signed contracts with the WWE as producers. Shane Helms, a.k.a. Wow. Hurricane Helms. And you are asking, what happens to Global Force Wrestling? I have no earthly idea.
Right.
Okay.
It just disappeared. Like,
well, here's the thing. It's still around, but we'll see what happens. I think, and this is what Jarrett might be thinking. Hey, They get it good here. They tell the folks what they do down there in Tennessee. And hopefully, they get to live. They fill the gap that OVW had, a Smokey Mountain Wrestling had, where guys can come down and do a little show, make a little change, burn down a building. Guys could just be starting their career slow. I don't know. So, maybe WWE helps them out a little bit from time to time when those guys are not doing that. Or maybe they just always on the road. And like you said, Keith, this shit just goes by the wayside.
Right. Because, I mean, I just don't understand. Like, it's just, y'all pay y'all sign on as producers, but, like, are you still going to have this business venture over here? Like, what are you doing?
Right.
Are we pulling a Booker T right now? Like, what's happening? I don't understand.
Right. So, I mean, and Booker T is a good example. He worked full time, not full time, but, you know, he was there every Raw. And then he went back to the crib and ran his school.
And his
school produces a weekly episodic show. I watched it on the Fight app. So, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, it can be done, and it could be actually helpful. And WWE hasn't been shy about getting talent from that AAS school.
Right.
Now, Global Force isn't a school, but it's definitely a smaller indie. And the way that WWE has been working, they would be plugged into everything. So, we'll see how that works out. So, when we talked about Dean walking away, right? There have been a rash of people asking for their release and asking to be let go, or the WWE let them go. So, most notable was Hideo Itami, right? Right. And I kind of figured after he didn't make it with the Cruiserweight title, like, that was going to be it for him. He's going to go back the way they sit. He got an immediate release. He can wrestle immediately. I think the idea is because he promised them he wouldn't wrestle in the U.S. He'll wrestle in Japan. And, you know, he'll go back to be a Kenta and have a good time. The legend that we know and love. Honestly, I think this dude just got bad breaks. Really, really bad breaks.
Yeah.
The office really fell in love with, like, somebody first. That guy was already a gold child. Nobody would see that he was really fucking up. That's like the rest of them. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, I mean, there's a lot of things going on there. But a lot of it really was just injuries, man. Injuries came at the wrong time for that man. And
It
just didn't work out. The Revival have apparently asked for their release. I don't know if they've gotten it. They have weeks where they have a good week that something happens to them. You know, it's up and down there, but for the most part, yes, they are around, but the Revival has asked for their release. I can see why. The whole Art and Tully thing just hasn't translated very well to this generation. The retirement of Maria and Mike Kanellis. Even though, it's funny, so Word on the Street came out that they asked for their release, and I've been seeing Maria every week after that. So,
because they
want to
know. They
want to
know.
I don't know, man.
It's a lot of rumors flying around.
Right.
But the people that are asking for their release, like, I don't think that Maria and Mike are asking for theirs. I don't believe that one. But with Kenta, because I'm gonna call him by the name he's calling himself now, I feel like that's understandable. You know, I could believe that one. It's not far fetched. Why certain people would ask for their release, especially with somebody like Hideo, because, I mean, he did get a bad break. But at the same time, I feel like the wrestlers in 205 Live get pushed to the side a lot. You know, Mustafa is the first one outside of Leo that has kind of broken free from that. But I feel like they get put in that box. And I've talked about this on a show before. So you get put in this box. In the cruiserweight division, like, that's all you do. And it kind of sucks because I feel like their talents, a lot of their talents, can be utilized outside of that, you know? And because most, the majority of them, if not all of them, are used to wrestling wrestlers of all sizes, types, you know. They don't just fall into that category. So, I mean, I just feel like it's kind of stifling for them to just be on 205 Live and nothing else, you know? So, I feel like he's not being utilized enough, and I can understand him asking for his release. I really do. So, but that's all I'm going to say on that. I'm not going to go too much into that. Because I'm not jumping on another soapbox at this point. Like, I'm done. So, but it is, yeah. I kind of believe it, but then I don't. Like, with him, I believe it. But, like, when it comes to, like, Maria and Mike, I don't believe it. I don't think they're going anywhere. So, well, I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Just like with the whole Dean Ambrose situation, I just feel like we just have to wait and see what's really happening. Like, what's going to really happen? What's really going on? Because if they grant Hideo his release, I'll understand it completely. I get it. but anybody else, I'm like, nah, bro, y'all ain't going nowhere. So, but I'm done with that. I ain't got nothing else. So, is that it for the news? Are we done with the news already? I feel like there's something else, but I'm pretty sure I'm forgetting what it is. So I'm not gonna try and remember. But I know I brought the whole Nia Jax thing with there being the backlash of her being, of her hurting people and whatnot, but I think that was it. Like, I don't know, man. I feel like I'm forgetting something. I feel like something else happened and I don't remember what it is. And it's gonna suck because we're going to get done with the show and I'm probably going to remember, like, tomorrow. I could have brought that up, and I didn't, and it's just terrible. So, but I leave it alone for right now. I ain't going to try to remember at the moment, because if I do that, I'm going to hurt my head, and it's going to be too much. But it's a lot that's going on in wrestling, and, you know, you just never know everything. You never know everything, and it just, stuff comes up. And you know tomorrow something else is going to happen, and we're going to get it, and we're going to, like, damn, like, we couldn't talk about that on the show. Like, it never fails. It never fails, y'all. We get to the news, and we get the recaps and all that kind of stuff. And then, like, the next day, something huge happens, and we be like, bro, we could have had that on the show. Like, it never fails. If it's not the next day, it's the day after that or the day after that. And it's just like, all right, like, this got to stop. Like, we could have literally had this on the show.
Yes.
And it just, and then we just be mad about it, but we get over it. Usually we kind of just throw it into the next show. But, yeah, it's still ridiculous. Like, why this couldn't have happened, like, 2 days ago before we did the show? Like, then we could have talked about it. But I get over it. So, you know. But I'm pretty sure whatever it is, I'm forgetting. I'm going to remember it in like the days. That's usually how that goes. That's not it. Usually how that is. So, all right, Keith, you ready for the recap?
Hey, man. Yeah, I think I got all the people who were not, who might be getting released or whatever, or asking for releases. I think I discussed everything I want to talk about in the news. Sanity isn't happy about that. Okay, recap. So let me get a Cliff Notes version of the recap of this, because we got to go to bed. Raw. We found out who was going to challenge for the Royal Rumble winners, because both of them showed up to Raw. One challenged Ronda Rousey, and the other one challenged Brock Lesnar. So, at least we know at WrestleMania, Ronda Rousey, Becky Lynch, Raw Women's title on the line, Universal title on the line, Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins versus Brock Lesnar. So, yeah, good times, interested. Something else I saw disturbing on Raw, I forgot, that I was like, huh? But I'll get back to it. Good stuff, good programming.
Yeah, true. Right. That was a segment I've been rewatching for the last couple of days, actually a few days, between Bayley and Becky that didn't show on TV. Becky had threw up the four at Bayley. Bayley threw it back at her. And, you know, Ronda in the ring looking all saucy. And but then they show that moment, and then you see Becky get in the ring. She tells Bayley, good job. Bayley nods at her, and she jumps out the ring, because when you see it on TV, you see Becky's back, so you really see it, but it was a something that they put up, WWE had actually put up on YouTube. It was actually out there before that. But I thought that was awesome. The four horse women thing is definitely getting a lot of steam, and I'm excited about that. I didn't like Bobby Lashley beating up on Finn Balor. I just thought that was dumb. I really did think that was just stupid. This whole Braun Strowman thing is getting out of control. And, I don't think there was anything else. I thought the Triple H, Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins segment was really good. I thought that was awesome.
Yeah.
I don't know where that's going, but that was awesome. So, but that's all I got for Raw. That's all I had for Raw.
All right. Yeah. That's it. Not a lot going on. I mean, I'm not really go ahead for it, but they did announce this, and they announced during Royal Rumble. Halftime Heat is returning. So it's the Super Bowl. Nobody wants to see the Rule 5 perform. And somebody got very comfortable with the idea that, hey, man, nobody wants to see Maroon 5 and Travis Scott. That's an absolutely terrible idea. Even though I like Sicko Mode. Is Drake going to be there? Because, I mean, Sicko Mode don't really work without Drake. Even though Drake might be there ruining somebody's season, cheering for him. But, you know, I don't know. Either way, nobody really wants to watch. So, for some fans, they'll have an alternative. Come to WWE Network, Facebook Watch, YouTube, whatever, and join Halftime Heat. It was a classic. Look up the Rock and Mankind Halftime Heat wrestling match in the empty arena.
I think I'm excited about halftime heat. I think it's going to be an interesting touch.
I'm glad that
they're having it.
They have the people in place to make a really good match. It's everybody from that brawl at the end of TakeOver, right? So Adam Cole, right. Chopper, and Gargano. DIY, basically, Adam Cole on one side against Ricochet, Velveteen Dream, and Aleister Black. Now.
Right, right.
I'm about to drop a spoiler. I would tell you to plug your ears. Keish, if you don't want to hear the spoiler, you might have to walk away. It has nothing to do with Halftime Heat.
I want to know.
Okay. Will the Velveteen Dream walk in with the NXT North American title around his waist? Maybe not, because that episode hasn't aired yet.
Come on.
But yes, Velveteen Dream is the North American NXT North American champion. Something that was confirmed via very various social media outlets, people who took pictures. Yeah, it's a thing.
What?
So
I'm excited.
But yeah, Halftime Heat going down. Worlds Collide premieres tomorrow, Saturday. It's NXT 205 Live, NXT UK. It's a tournament to see the winner will get a shot at the championship of their choosing for the belt. So check it out. They were all filmed over the Royal Rumble weekend. Still, nonetheless, they'll release the thing so everybody can see it and watch along with it. I think it's going to be good. SmackDown, Daniel Bryan introduced a global sensitive belt, I guess, which not using, you know, a bunch of, it just made it like a hippie belt. I like it. I think it goes with his character. Mm-hmm. Him being an asshole vegan environmentalist works because everybody knows one. So, just like I've worked with a few like, oh, yes, I'm vegan. Keith, you know you're eating poison. Do you know what happens to the chickens? You know what they do to the chickens before they put them in a big crowd and they electrocute them all. I'm like, does that make them taste good? Because the shit's delicious. I can't really tell you. Like, Keith, do I respect them? I'm eating them. Why the fuck do I care? I'm eating them. Like, I've crossed the line early in the game.
I'm glad that I have, the vegans that I know aren't like that. They don't shove it down your throat. You know what I'm saying? Like, the vegans I know, they're not like that. They let you eat your bacon and let you go on about your business. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't have time. I just don't. Like, people, you know what's funny? Folks be like, you know what that's made out of? And I'm like, whatever it is good as hell because I love eating shit. Okay, like, I don't do all that. I don't care. Like, I don't care. Like, let me eat my food and let me be, okay? Like, I don't have time for all that. No. We're not going to do this, okay? Like, I really honestly have never, like, when people decide they want to tell you about your food, let me eat my food. Let me do. And this whole direction they're going with Daniel Bryan is really terrible. Like, I don't like it. I'm like, no, y'all can do better. Like, he can be a heel without doing all of that. And that new belt is terrible. That new belt is terrible. It looks like it's made out of those to-go trays that I get from the airport. Like, I don't want to see this. Like, what are y'all doing? I'm better with him. And this is terrible. But, you know, to each his own, whatever. I'm not even. So. But, I ain't finna get into it. But I go, you know, it's funny. I go on my soapbox a lot tonight. I'm gonna slide on off that thing. I really am. I'm gonna stop stepping up on that. Because that's what have us on here for a whole nother hour. It is what it is, though. So. Oh, Keith, let's talk about your boy, R-Truth. Let's get into that.
Oh, yes. United States champion, R-Truth.
Yes,
hey.
Yes.
I thought R-Truth was married. Him and Carmella got a thing?
You know what? I don't know. He's married. He is married. They're not a thing. I think this is just for the show. I don't think they don't have a thing. Unless R-Truth done got divorced or something. I don't know. But I don't know. Last time I checked, he had a wife. So I don't know. I don't know how this is going. I'm glad it's funny because I'm like, yeah, I'm glad he took out two dudes in the same night. I was like, oh, shit. I was excited. I was like, oh, my truth.
So, yeah, man. I think we're in for another interesting week. I think we're in for a lot going down in the world of professional wrestling. And with that being said, I think we're going to wrap this one up. Keish, any part? Oh, Super Bowl is going down Sunday. Keish, who you got? Who you got?
You know what, Keish? I'm just ready for all this to be over with, bro. I'm not going to lie. I'm tired. They got to be doing 12-hour shifts at work because of this thing. I'm just ready for all to be over. Like, I just want it all to be done with. Please,
so,
thank you. Like,
you hoping there's a game where everybody lose. Like,
you know who I'm pulling for? My sleep. That's what I'm pulling for.
Right.
I'm pulling for some rest. Like, I'm tired.
Okay, I hear you.
I'm tired. I'm going to be at work when the Super Bowl happens anyway. So, I'm ready for this thing. Just go ahead, have to be over with so everybody pack their stuff and leave. I ain't got time.
Right.
I don't need y'all all. Yeah, y'all a crowd. Y'all go home. Let y'all go ahead and bounce out. Like, we already full. Like, nah. And everybody that has a hotel room on Fulton Industrial, I'm praying for y'all. I really am. Because, y'all should have checked the room before y'all did that. Right. So, but that's neither here nor there. I'm done with that. That's what I think of the Super Bowl.
But, yeah, for that, I will say this. I hope the Rams win. But I ain't one of those people who hate the Patriots. I mean, history is history. Tom Brady gets 6 rings in 18 years. Good for him. Good for everybody who made it. And, you know, that's it. So, we're going to check this thing off and tell y'all good night. And we will be back next week. And we're gearing up for Elimination Chamber. That's it.
That's right.
Peace.
Bye.